We had an idiot first president. He's incompetent. I fired his ass. Our new guy is crushing it. We're killing it with Nick. It's all the 1500s are sold out. Just got a big order in, so we're good. We're going to have a profitable fourth quarter.
Hey, everyone, and welcome back to Investing Guide. Dan Bilzerian, the multimillionaire king of Instagram, as some would say. But before his Instagram days, some people thought Dan Bilzerian was some sort of ex-army specialist, a Navy SEAL. This may be due to his movie roles, his camouflage pants he likes to wear, or his past relationship with the US Army. But today, we're going to tell you all about the shocking evidence of why, in fact, he is not. Make sure you stay until the end, as you don't want to miss the most fascinating truth about what happened. Dan claims that he finished SEAL training twice. In this video, we're going to break down why Dan Bilzerian's military record is completely false. As you know, there are people out there who genuinely believe that at one point, Dan was a Navy SEAL. Dan Bilzerian attended basic SEAL training in the year 1999, but as you can see, he can't even get a jet ski into the water. And a Navy SEAL who has something to say about Dan Bilzerian online is none other than Robert O'Neill, who claimed to have killed Osama bin Laden. More on that later. Dan Bilzerian went to military school from an early age. After people made fun of his dad for going to prison, Bilzerian acted out in school and was quickly expelled from two different schools, after which he was then sent to a military academy in an attempt to improve his behavior. This is where Dan's military history begins. After school was not working out for Dan, it is unknown to us whether he graduated high school or not. Dan found himself with not many options on what to do in life, so enrolled himself back into the army, doing training to become a Navy SEAL. BUDS stands for Basic Underwater Demolition SEAL Training. It's a 6-month selection program broken down into 3 phases that any aspiring Navy SEAL has to complete. The training is designed to increase mental and physical stamina, as well as filtering out trainees who are not up to the task. We have been able to identify that Dan was in the BUDS class 229, 238, and 239. Dan got dropped in class 229 itself, even completed the toughest week of the training known as Hell Week, but he was then dropped for compound stress fractures in his leg. Later on, Dan has claimed that he was offered $6,000 per month disability allowance as a veteran, but he requested to go back and give SEAL training another go, instead even with his injury still at large, and bravely returned to the SEAL training program to try it again. Dan joined up with Class 238 and claims to have made it 2 days before graduating, but somehow got moved back to Class 239. In Class 239, Dan claims to have made it to a few weeks before graduation until he was dropped for, quote, no good reason. However, it has been allegedly put forward by Team Guys on softrap.com that Dan was admin dropped for a safety violation at the shooting range. It's common for new recruits in military or law enforcement who have little or no firearm experience before coming in. However, there is also another reason why Dan was dropped. There's a story circulating online of how during the third phase of evaluation, possibly Land Navy, Dan fell asleep in the field and had failed to regroup with the class students and instructors alike who were waiting for Dan, but he was nowhere to be found. Later, Dan tried to blame his classmates for not trying to wake him up. According to the original poster of the class, they even did a skit to the Pearl Jam song, Better Man, which they all performed in. Instead of saying, can't find a better man, they said, can't find Bilzerian. Dan has then gone out and told numerous people that he did in fact complete SEAL training and other military achievements that were not true. According to Dan, in total, he did 510 days SEAL training. It's meant to be a 6-month course, but went on for a year and a half only to get dropped. He believes maybe it saved his life though, because a whole lot of his buddies in his class died being a Navy SEAL. Though Bilzerian failed to make it through SEAL training, his broken leg and honorable discharge.
He goes, you realize that we are going to be paying you disability and we're saying that you're disabled and you want me to approve a request for you to go to the hardest military training in the world.
Allegedly gave him a $6,000 per month disability allowance as a veteran, which he used to fund a business and criminology degree at the University of Florida. This was also where he began gambling, a habit that allegedly led him to making his fortune. Although his days in the Navy SEALs are over, it can be seen through Dan's actions that he did want to, or at least does pride himself on the fact that he was once a part of the training. Once Dan left the military, he's always implemented SEAL qualities into his brand, such as the beard and the camo shorts. He even paid to be in the film as a Navy SEAL in the film Lone Survivor. He mentioned that he loaned $1 million for the film's budget in exchange for at least 8 minutes of screen time and 80 words of dialogue in the film. However, when the film came to air, he appears in the film for less than 1 minute, with most of his role being deleted from the final cut, which was apparently not the deal made. So Dan sued the producers and director, Peter Berg. Dan Bilzerian was near the Las Vegas shooting when it occurred. Dan Bilzerian often brags about his seemingly lethal competence. He wrote on one of his pictures of a table full of guns, "My greatest fear is that someone will break in and I won't be able to decide which hashtag gun to shoot them with." There is even the official Dan Bilzerian video game about shooting things. But on October 1st, 2017, during one of the worst shootings in Las Vegas and in American history, Dan, who was nearby at the time, is seen running away from the gunfire. Combat veteran, part of the Marine Corps, and a Medal of Honor recipient, Dakota Mayer was not happy that Dan was running away instead of helping the people who needed it, saying, "We look at people's followers, we look at how cool their life looks on Instagram, and we start looking up to them," Mayer said in the beginning of his video, clarifying that he used to highly rate Bilzerian and happened to have got caught up in the hype. Dan responded to Dakota Mayer, but was quickly shut down in his response by a Navy SEAL, which was none other than Robert O'Neill, who claims to be the one that shot and killed Al-Qaeda leader Osama bin Laden during a raid in his Abbottabad compound in May 2011, and has been making numerous remarks on Bilzerian, from calling him a coward to photoshopping photos aimed to take a dig at Dan for various reasons after Dan's response. Those who have spent time with Dan, however, know that there are guns lying around everywhere in literally every room, as Jonathan Grotenstein, a poker player and senior All In magazine contributor, tells the media. Before you walk in, his security guard takes you aside and warns you not to touch them, because they're all chambered and loaded. You look at all the girls and all the guns, and you may wonder how it is all going to end. Is Dan sad he never became a Navy SEAL? Is this why he wears camouflaged pants and loves guns? Or is he happy he didn't become one because of the way his life turned out? Dan Bilzerian didn't make it through SEAL training, but ended up doing okay. Daniel Brandon Bilzerian was born in Tampa, Florida on December 7, 1980. His parents were Paul Bilzerian, a corporate takeover specialist of Armenian descent, and Terry Stephen. Paul, who made a significant amount of money on Wall Street, set up trust funds for Dan and his brother, Adam. Dan rarely saw his father, a Vietnam veteran who was frequently away on business, and Bilzerian has pointed to this lack of attention as a possible reason for his loud playboy personality as an adult. There's been some controversy regarding Paul Bilzerian, who was convicted of fraud in order to pay a fine of $62 million, which he only repaid about $4 million as of 2017. Dan was unaware of his father's criminal actions until a morning drive to school at 10 years old when Paul informed him that he was going to prison. Paul was found guilty of stock and tax fraud, and Dan faced frequent bullying from classmates about his imprisoned father. Bilzerian acted out and was quickly expelled from two different schools, after which he was sent to a military academy in an attempt to improve his behavior. With the family's reputation tarnished and Paul out on parole, they decided to move to Utah for a fresh start. Dan later joined and signed up for the Navy SEAL training, and that's how it all began. While you're here, go ahead and click on one of these two videos on your screen. See you there!